What is going on, everyone? Do you guys know of, not do you know, have you experienced the grumpy music store sales guy? Maybe they only exist in Toronto. When you go into a music store, do you ever run into the condescending, forever present sales guy who knows everything, knows so much that makes you wonder, why is he working in a music store full time and not, you know, the biggest musician on earth, like the biggest star on the planet? Like, what is he doing there? Because that's what he acts like. He acts like he's forever disgruntled about life and that your presence only gets in the way of his, I don't know, his trip to the top. Anyhow, like Toronto, we have certain music stores where you have pretty good, you know, customer service, where you walk in, people help you, and they, you know, they tell you what you want to know. They kind of, you know, guide you and show you, you know, what they have to offer. And some of them may even help you get a deal or get you, you know, give you the drop on certain things that may help you save a dollar or two. Then you have the disgruntled guy who always has a problem, who seems to be, I don't want to say it's condescending, but every question or, you know, inquiry that you may have, you just get the hint that he feels like you're just like kind of not worth his time. Here's my thoughts on what they may be going through. And if you have experienced a disgruntled music store sales guy or girl, this is my observation on why they may be this way. This is what I do when I walk into a music store, because you have no choice. I'll go into a music store, usually it's Long & McQuaid, and you just, I eavesdrop. You can't help but hear what people say, and I hear the silliest conversations. You know, it's usually, you get the guy that, or the, you know, the couple, two guys or two girls or whatever, they walk in and they're both musicians. And then one's the expert guy who's like showing his friend all this gear. And he's like, oh yeah, this does this and this does this. And you hear all this false information that this guy or girl is spewing out about things that they really don't know about. And me listening to this stuff, I just kind of got a, be like, oh my gosh, why don't you just be quiet? It's just ridiculous to listen to. And it gets to the point sometimes where you just gotta leave, because it's like you are just either trying to impress who you're with, or you're either the type of person that just reads a whole bunch of stats on whatever gear you're talking about and you really don't have any experience with it. You're just spewing out rhetoric just for the sake of doing it. Which brought me to think that, okay, if I spend 15 or 20 minutes in this store and I'm already ready to hurl, how does the guy feel who works here and gets to hear all this stuff all the time? It may make you disgruntled. No excuse, that's your job. You chose to work there. You're supposed to put up with that stuff. Maybe, I don't know, deal with it some other way. But maybe that's where these guys get this attitude from. And of course, it could very well be that they're failed at what they do and they're quarantined to work as a musician salesperson for the rest of their life in their hopes of being a rock star or a superstar DJ or, I don't know, a super producer have failed. Likely. But it just brought me to think, like, is it just, you know, it's not true, because I've experienced this in a lot of countries and a lot of stores that I went to. So it's not just Toronto, but what are your experiences, if any, with the disgruntled salesperson? Do you just, I mean, I don't usually ask for help, but it's, you know, what I do ask for is like directions, like, do you have this thing? If so, where is it? Just show me where it is so I can go there. But if you had this experience with these people, how do you deal with it? What does it make you think? Do you feel like, I don't know, drop kicking somebody like that? Maybe smacking them, roughing them up a bit, I don't know. Let me know. Anyway, subscribe to me here on YouTube. Follow me here on Facebook. Not here on Facebook. Follow me on Facebook. Subscribe to me here on YouTube. Follow me on Instagram. Follow me on Pinterest. Follow me on Snapchat. And of course, go to thedaydreamsound.com where you can get all my music, all my stuff, and it's good stuff. Anyhow, peace.